Yo, what is up, guys? So we have a really nasty two-card lockdown that's going to make it so your opponent cannot Yu-Gi-Oh! And even really play at all. But anyways, the main thing that we're actually looking for, this is a single purchase that just lets you go ahead and banish your entire hand. You get it at any monster, but if you do, you can't normal or special summon any monsters except for that monster, but that's all you need. The two cards that you need to pull this off are going to be 5 Arc Magician and Denko Sekka. The rest of them, well, you can go ahead and search it out with single purchase anyways. So it's a pretty consistent variant, but let me go ahead and explain how this lockdown works. And I can't believe no one has thought of this, but shout out to my boy DevPRO for sending this in. But it's a two card lockdown that will allow you to pull off the most difficult Yu-Gi-Oh! Combos. And I'm not talking about like a Wave Motion Cannon or an Exodia. He just went ahead and decided to put these in. But I know a lot of you guys that are fans of running ridiculously hard things to pull off. Like previously, like the Neo stuff, that was really difficult to pull off. So you would never pull that off in a real game. But with the addition of course, having the ability to lock your opponent down with just two cards, you can basically sit there and potentially draw out every single combo piece you need for your Egyptian gods, or pretty much anything. Anything that would be too difficult to pull off, you're going to be able to pull off really easy with this two-card setup. So, let me go and explain what the heck is going on. So, Denko Sekka has the effect where, while you control no set spell or traps, neither player can set spell or traps or activate spell or trap cards that are set on the field. So basically, this makes it so your opponent cannot use any of their traps, or essentially place anything that would need to be set beforehand, but basically it just shuts down traps, or them just setting cards in general, which is going to combo really well with your Perform Pop 5 Rainbow Magician. I'll get into that effect in a second. I'm just going to go ahead and play another play here, so there's something to talk about during the background here. But Perform Pop 5 Rainbow Magician has this effect that applies to both players. So each player applies one of these effects based on the number of set cards in their spell and trap zone. If they have 0, all monsters they control cannot attack or activate their effects. There are certain effects that are continuous, but no monster can activate its effect. So you can see over here the Fairy Tale Snow will not be able to activate the effect to put the Sekka face down. No Minerva. Again, it negates all of their effects with 5 Arc Magician. But if you happen to have 4 more set cards, the attack of all monsters they control becomes double their original attack. That effect doesn't really apply here. So what we're trying to do, guys, is summon Denko Sekka and then place this down. It's a 2-card lockdown that makes it so your opponent cannot ever attack or use any of their monster effects or any of the back row that would need to be set ahead of time. Yeah, there will be other cards, but for the most part, most people aren't playing any like Destruction or other cards like Book of Moon in 2018. Like, those just aren't cards people play. But yeah, you'll be able to pull off anything from Exodia to Wave Motion OTK to, again, anything that would be considered difficult to pull off. Well, you don't have to really worry about that if you want to go ahead and pull off. I'm assuming most people would quit on you before this would even get to this point in the first place. However, again, most people won't be able to deal with this because a lot of decks, especially nowadays, they are all relied off of whatever monsters they have, you know, in their deck to kind of pull off what they need to do. So yeah, it is a pretty good lockdown. It's not a unbeatable lockdown by any means. You could still definitely have certain cards, but those cards would be something I would consider a little bit more rare. Like, unless your opponent is playing like Exodia or something really random, for the most part, you're going to be able to destroy most of them. Yeah, I guess if you happen to tribute your opponent's Sekka, that could be an option as well. But again, you're not going to be able to set any cards. In fact, I mean, I don't even know what Pendulum set other than like the space-time. There's usually not too many. You can see there's not other cards that they would be able to even set in the first place. Even if the Sekka was not here, he would never be able to set cards. And if you can't set cards, you can never attack or activate monster effects. This card is actually really, really nasty. Eventually, what you could technically do is if you happen to negate Sekka's like effect, and remember, this is stopping the effect from activating. There is still obviously continuous effects that would apply, but if you were to negate Sekka's effect, then set like multiple back row, it would not actually work because you also have to control no set spell or traps yourself. So keep that in mind in case you want to do something crazy. You could use anti-spell fragrance. I guess you made like Temple of the Kings, activated that first. Then if you really wanted to, you could make it so you would lock your opponent out of spells. And at that point, you lock them out of spells, all monster effects, nothing can attack, and then obviously traps because you can't set cards. Then you have a more unbeatable lockdown, but in this case we're playing Exodia. I don't know if I would necessarily consider it, this is like a deck that you need to play Exodia or some type of FTK, or no, not FTK, but an OTK variant of like something to win instantly. I think you can actually try to make this another deck potentially, and just be able to run over your opponent via just getting enough cards in your hand, then basically getting rid of your own Denko Sekka. Then you can set something, and then you can go off completely with your cards effects. And remember, your opponent can't do anything. Look at this opponent's board. Remember, there's no attacking, no effects. So even though he has this massive amount of cards and all these strong monsters, he can't do anything. This is why it is like a very nasty lockdown. Again, guys, it's a two-card lockdown. Very rare to have two cards be able to lock your opponent out, especially since you can run the card that lets you banish three. I'm going to go into it if it's in the graveyard. Oh, it's not in here. We'll go over it when we talk about the deck profile, but there was... this is the extra deck from the Pot of Indulgence. But there's a card that does search it out. It requires you to banish three cards out of your hand, but it does search out any monster, which was showcased off, and I believe the first play. But anyways, now that you guys have seen it in action, let's go ahead and talk about a deck profile in case any of you guys want to run it. Like I said, there was... let me go to... over here. This one is the one that he was playing, the searchable card, which was the single purchase. And this one isn't in the deck profile, but I wanted to go over this card's effect because I thought it was pretty unique. So if you have three more cards in your hand other than this card, and none of them are monsters, you banish your entire hand face up to add one monster from your deck to your hand. If you do, you can't normal or special monsters for the rest of the turn, except for monsters with that name. So yeah, that's what single purchase does. It's very minus, but I mean, all you really need to do is have either 5 Arc or the Sekka, and then you just search out the other one. Yeah, it's very hefty in the investment, but at the end of the day, you're locking your opponent out of basically playing any Yu-Gi-Oh! Even if they had already gone. That's pretty nasty, because even if they have set cards, remember, Sekka is going to go ahead and stop that. But he went ahead and sent in the deck profile for the Exodia variant. There's probably a lot more things that you can do. Like I said, I think what would probably be better, especially if you're running single purchase, obviously Exodia makes things much more difficult. But that said, run something that would be very difficult to pull off and you'll have a good time. Again, there's so many crazy Yu-Gi-Oh! Combos that are really, really next to impossible to pull off. And this will just lock your opponent down pretty consistently and let you actually pull that off. So we've got the deck profile for the Exodia variant. So first off, obviously we're running all copies of Exodia, because I think that that's one of the most iconic win conditions in the game, and well, why not throw it in here, because your opponent cannot play. So yeah, we have the Exodia set, then we have three copies of the Sekka, we have one copy of Bro Hunter, so this is going to let you add any Light Thunder type, which Sekka happens to be. And then we have one copy of Lazuli, that is of course for your Brilliant Fusion, and if you use this you get your additional summon anyways, so there you go for that. Then we have of course three copies of the 5 Rainbow Magician, which is obviously required for the combo. Then we have one day of Peace, we have three copies of Cup of Ace, two copies of Indulgence, we have one Upstart, one copy of Card Destruction, three copies of Golden Bamboo Sword, three copies of Magical Mallet, one Dark Factory of Mass Production, two copies of Duality, three copies of Hand Destruction, two Brilliant, one Shard of Greed, one Contract with Don Thousand, three copies of the Cursed Bamboo Sword. For the extra deck, we've got the Gemknight Fusion, we've got the Topologic, we got Borreload, Boral Sword, Suryuja, two of those. We've got Firewall Dragon, Griffin, Trisbania, Unicorn, three copies of Phoenix, we've got one Cerberus, one Witchling. These are other cards that he was probably trying out before but just didn't like them or swapped it up for the build. Like I said, if you're playing the Exodia build, you can go ahead and actually not put in single purchase. But I think this is going to add a lot more consistency to the deck, but it depends on what you're playing. Like I said, there's so many difficult combos to pull off in Yu-Gi-Oh! That this deck would technically allow. He was also playing a few more Shard of Greeds and some Wave Motion Cannons. But at the end of the day, this is kind of a cheesy deck. But I think that it is kind of cool to see a really simple two-card lockdown. Can't believe no one thought of this. In fact, I think this card, the Perform Pop 5 Arc Magician, is just insane. Just being able to make it so your opponent is forced to actually just set one card if they even want to do anything, if they want to attack or activate any monster effects. In fact, a lot of people won't even read this card. You'd be surprised if you just activate this card and you tell your opponent go, and then they just summon a monster, they're like, what the heck, where's my effect? And they didn't have that set card, so they just lost out on it. But obviously, you'll know exactly what the heck this card does. But anyways, Thank you, DevPRO, for sending in this deck. If you guys got any cool decks that are just absolutely crazy, like this one over here, feel free to send in an email and attach the YRP file, and you can get a shout out just like my boy DevPRO here sent this one in. And if you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button to see more crazy Yu-Gi-Oh! Decks like the two card lockdown with the rainbow Sekka lockdown. And you, again, your opponent cannot Yu-Gi-Oh! For the most part. Yeah, there are some cards. It's not like an unbeatable lockdown, but very good lockdown indeed. Anyways, thanks for watching, guys. Peace out. Have a good one. I'm signing out.